been a lovely 2 weekends, actually. But before I go on any further, I am actually going to just take care of some business issues. Make sure the restroom is through the double door on the right in the back. I'm sure you probably have figured that by now. Please silence your cell phone. That would be great. It will be a good time to do so. Great. My name is Yuka Tanaka, and I am the board president for the Junior Bach Festival. And again, welcome to concert number 10, our final concert. We have played in various different cities in the Bay Area, including Berkeley, Alamo, San Francisco, Menlo Park, San Mateo, and Portola Valley. So we are everywhere. In addition to the 9 concerts that happened and the 10th one today, we also had Bach in the Subway, which took place at the downtown Berkeley Park Station on March 21st. On March 21st, we also launched our first virtual concert. And of course, why March 21st? Well, do you know whose birthday that was? Bach's birthday. Now, can anybody tell me how old he would be if he were alive today? He was born in 1685. Okay, 337. Thank you for your answer. Great. Okay, so here we are celebrating his music even 337 years later. We have 4 more virtual concerts coming up, and they will be launched next weekend. So check the website, and there will be links to the concerts. I'd like to thank all the board members that are here today to make everything work. But in particular, I want to thank Spencer Larson. You all met him on your way in. And without his tireless work of just doing everything possible for this festival, we won't be here today. So thank you again, Spencer. And again, thanks to everyone for the your cooperation for the warm-up today. I know it was a little unusual knowing that the piano was in the background and we have this other instrument over here. Well, I just wanted to let you know that this is a harpsichord for some of you who may not have seen a real harpsichord. It's a precursor to the piano. It's a keyboard instrument that was active basically from 1600 to roughly 1750. And as you know, there's no pedal. And if you want to come take a look later, there are 2 levels of keyboards. The keyboard colors are flipped. Blacks are the naturals. And the naturals are white. I mean, the accidentals are white. And so you will also be treated to the sound of the harpsichord, which will be great. And you might be wondering why we have the music chest and the way the lid is sort of looking like it's closed and not flipped backwards as you would in a piano. Well, it's all part of the historically informed performance, actually. We actually do not memorize any music that's before 1750, so we are allowed to use music, not just in chamber music, but in solo pieces as well, and so therefore the music. That little clock over there, here, keeps the sound reflecting so that it goes out to the audience more. I mean, we can, of course, open it, and it tends to be claustrophobic, so when we practice, we tend to have the flap open. But in a big space like this, it would be nice to capture all the sound that one can hear from the harpsichord, and that's why the flap is down. So I just want to let you know, because we do have the live harpsichord here today. Please remember to stay till the end of the show, because there will be certificates and a great photo op for the parents. And one change in the program is Marina Yu, a singer, could not be here this evening. but you may catch her in the virtual concert. So please check her out in the virtual concert. So without further ado, I'd like to start the concert.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.